storage tanks and pipeline. So I would like to request Shri Shridhar Bangar sir, please start their session. Bangar sir, the forum for you.
Rakesh sir, thanks a lot. First of all, aapko, I'm very much thankful to you for giving us opportunity in a short notice to arrange webinar such webinar. Aaj mere saath, I am having colleagues with me. Atul Gharat is there. He is API inspector. Then Abhijit Therondekar. He is also API inspector. Then our sales manager Atul Abhay Sawant is there, who is coordinating with Rakesh sir from last many days. So basically, we will share you our presentation screen that you can see on your computer, and I will go one by one slides. If you have any questions or anything, you can raise your hand or you can ask, send a text message. We will unmute that particular person, and that person can ask his queries. Then we will try to rectify his, or we can try to give his answers to his query. Is it fine? Ekbar unmute karo sir. Rakesh sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is okay, right?
Yes. Please start.
Okay. So now we are going through our initial presentation. We are having some equipments also demonstration, but we'll see once our session expires, that presentation part. We'll try to show you some technology. You might be using in your terminals from many days by using our services like LFET and WFMPI and all those things we are regularly doing in your area also for your all terminal storage tanks. So I will ask Abhay to go with the slides. Okay, so hope everybody is viewing this presentation slides. Please confirm. Rakesh sir, aapko dikh raha hai ye?
Yes.
Okay, so basically aap sab logon ko pata hi hai ki hum log LFET services aur ultrasonic thickness gauging और बाकी की सारी सर्विसेज आपके टर्मिनल्स में काफी टाइम से प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं. सो ये सर्विसेज हम लोग काफी टाइम से प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं आपके टर्मिनल्स में, एंड यू आर मच अवेयर अबाउट ऑल दिस सर्विसेज. बट अदर देन दिस वी आर हैविंग सम अदर थिंग्स आल्सो, लाइक वी आर डूइंग 100% EPA 653 इंस्पेक्शन for your storage tanks. So in that, what is happening? What are the things we are checking periodically, and what are the things we are providing you rectification point of view or certification point of view? All those things we can discuss here today. So I will go one by one slides, and if you are having any doubts, any queries, you can raise your hand. So next. As you might be aware that Testex NDT India formed in 2001 in India. Basically, Testex Inc. USA is a US-based company which is providing this equipment, this technology called electromagnetic principle for storage tanks, pipelines, heat exchangers, boilers, and any other things need to inspect in the plant or in the industry. We are having solution for that. And our Testex Inc. USA, located in Pittsburgh, we are having our head office in Pittsburgh, which was started in 1987. All our equipment, what we are using for inspection, are manufactured by Testex Inc. So they are the manufacturer of the equipments. They are selling these equipments worldwide. in India, we are providing services, not only in India, but in all Gulf countries like Qatar, Oman, Asian countries like Philippines, Malaysia, all those countries we are providing services from here, India. So as I told you that we are having number of branches in USA itself, overseas also like UK, Japan, France, Argentina, we are having branches. And in India, we are having five branches, including your Delhi office also. So in India, head office is in Mumbai, and we are having Chennai branch, we are having Delhi branch, we are having Kolkata branch, we are having Vadodara branch. So here we are going to discuss about total tank solution. It means in periodically when you are opening your tank for M&I, you are doing, at present you are doing LFET inspection, that is tank floor scanning, then you are doing ultrasonic inspection, and you might be doing some this thing, ultrasonic thickness, WFMPI, and all other technology. But we have started this new tank, total tank solution technology, in which we are giving you 100% inspection, not only LFET, not only MPI, not only ultrasonic thickness, but in that we are doing 100% API 653 inspection, and as per OISD 129, tank external inspection, internal inspection, visual inspection, we are covering in that. Visual inspection, external, internal, we are providing photographs and all those things. Then we are doing LFET for bottom scanning, 100% low frequency electromagnetic technique, which we are doing at your terminals. Then for weld inspection, we are having magnetic particle inspection, then vacuum box test inspection, then diapenetrant, then chalk test also we are doing for welding inspection. In ultrasonic testings, we are doing shell, bottom, roof, nozzle thickness measurements. And we are having one wiper crawler system, which you can erect on your tank shell. And it's a robotic crawler system, which can take ultrasonic readings. It's a spot readings. We can generate, I think, four to eight directions, like 12 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 8 o'clock directions. On each plate, we can take 3, 4, 5 readings. It's go vertically. It takes ultrasonic reading. So you need not to erect the scaffolding for that ultrasonic testing. So that is the advantage. Then we are giving you 100% API 653 inspection. We are giving our conclusion, what recommendation you have to do. And again, based on our report, we are giving you remaining life calculations also. So your tank will be run for near future, how many years as per calculation. As per API 653 guidelines, we are generating reports. In API 653, we are not doing only visual inspection. We are doing your tank verticality test. In that verticality, we are using total station, which normally people are using for that road, these things. So that total station systems we can use, by using that system, you can check your tank verticality, ovalness of the tank, tank bottom settlement. So all those things we can inspect with the laser technology. So the readings are very accurate. So you will come to know that whether that your tank settlement is there, or your tank is in good shape, or as per API, you need to do some rectification in that. So all those things we can do. I think Rakesh sir's speaker, you can unmute, because I should know that you are getting
some. Okay, I can
hear. Any questions in this?
No, sir. Go ahead.
Okay. So you can see that total station, one small pocket instrument you can see there. It's like a digital meter, which is having laser beam technology. We are erecting somewhere in the middle in the tank, and we can check your roundness of the tank, your vertical settlement of the tank. So earlier people are using that Gavandi Olamba, that plumb line. So that plumb line, when air is there, it may be going here and there, and you are not getting proper readings. So here we are using this laser beam technology. So you will get 100% correct readings for that.
And we can sir,
yes sir.
आपने perform किया है this laser वाला?
Sir, we are performing this inspection from last 2 years, and all this Castrol India pan India Castrol plants, we are regularly doing this inspection. Apart from that, Indian Oil Tanking Limited, Raipur and Mumbai, we are having annual rate contract for this inspection. And we did some tanks in terminals in BPCL, Chennai, I believe.
Okay.
HPCL Wadala, we did some tanks. And Aegis terminals.
Please.
Yeah, I will share you some reports also at the end of my seminar. You can see on the computer screen also. I asked Abhay to pull one report, so that you will get idea that how we are generating the report, how we are giving the readings for that tank settlements and roundness, and based on that, what is our conclusion and everything. I will share you that report also. Okay, should I go ahead?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So you can see here, when we are doing that visual inspection, so we are getting tanks like this, shell corrosion, earthings. We are checking all those things. We can check shell corrosion, earthings, if shell basement is correct or not, if any weeds has been there. Due to a lot of time has been spent, then roof nozzles, how the condition of the roof nozzles, shell fire pipeline, then ladders, then roof corrosion is there or not. So this is, comes under visual inspection. We are giving 100% report for this, what are our findings in external and internal inspection during our API 653 inspector, qualified. API 653 inspector will check all those things and he will give his recommendations.
But then,
yeah, then at the same time, for your tank bottom, we are doing regularly low frequency electromagnetic technique, LFET. That is a part of that API when you are going to do this total stay solution. Most of you people might be knowing, because all your terminals are using this technology. But once again, I will just explain the technology. In that, this scanner will be there, which is having electromagnetic field generation magnet, horseshoe type magnet is there. In between, sensors is there. And on the top of our scanner, LED lights are there. So when we apply electromagnetic field at the low frequency, because of ferrous material, we have to use low frequency in hertz. So when we apply electromagnetic field, the field will go to your plate thickness. So, and if any pitting, any corrosion, any distortion is there, the phase and amplitude angle of that field will distort. That I will show you in this screen, you can see. When it comes on that pit, you will get LED light glows, you will get phase angle shift, you will get amplitude shift. You can see once again. So when we are doing scanning, we are directly stopping at that area. When we are getting indication, we are marking that area and cross verifying by ultrasonic measurements again, because it's the two times confirmation whether that defect is means relevant or non-relevant. Because sometimes if any cold work, if any non-relevant defects are also there, weld splatters and all those indications also, it will show like defect-like indication. So for that reason, we are just scanning, marking that area and cross-verifying by the ultrasound. And afterwards, we are giving 100% report of our, your tank bottom. So advantage of this LFET is if you do ultrasonic thickness measurement on each plate, it is very difficult to cover 100% area. But with this technology, you can scan your entire tank and in a very short time. Because if your 18 meter dia tank, it's around 250 square meter, we can cover in a one day, which is not possible by ultrasonic even in a month. So that is the main advantage, and it's a fast and cost effective. You need not to open your tank for many days for scanning and all. So once you open, just clean grid blast, or you have to give good surface preparation. After your surface preparation, our people enters, they inspect the tank, and we are giving the reports. So this is again a part of API 653, whichever area we are doing that total solution. There, apart from API 653 observations, that verticality and all those things, we are giving this bottom floor plate scanning report also. So this is our system for tank floor scanning. You can see that there, that scanner is there, electronic box, then laptop will be there. So it's an online scanning system, and you can see below there is a small scanner which is called Junior Scanner. We are using that scanner to reach hard to reach areas in the tanks, like below the pipelines or that sump area and periphery of the tank. Whichever area our senior scanner cannot go, that area we are using that junior scanner. That the reason for this scanner scanning, we have to cover 100% area, and we need not to it should not be there any unscanned area. So it should be 100% inspection. That's the reason we are using these multiple scanners. This is something called again tank floor scanner, which is called Wingspan. Basically, it requires for bigger dia tanks. For your terminal storage tanks, it may not require. It may not require. We are doing this scanning in refineries, mainly in refineries like Reliance Jamnagar, where the tank diameters are 92 meter dia or 79 meter dia, where they are having some time limitations. They have to scan entire tank within 8 to 10 days. So there we are using this scanner. With this scanner, the productivity will be higher than our normal scanning system. There we are doing 250 square meter, and here we can do around 400 to 500 square meter in area in a day. So advantage of this LFET is we can do 100% scanning. We can tell you the soil side and product side defects. If any corrosion, any fitting, anything is happening, we can do that. As I told you, that scanning is done at the rate of 1 to 1.35 square meter per minute. Again, if you calculate in the square meter, it will come to 50 square meter area in a day. Here it has been written minimal surface preparation required, but the plate should not be having rust, scale, water. It's our dry technology. We need not to use any coupler when we are doing scanning, but there should not be a loose scaling or all those things. Because our, if your surface is good, then the scanning is also you can do in a correct way, and there are less chances for missing the any defects. And as I told you, like confirmation of defects is also done by ultrasonic testing. So depth of penetration is limited up to 19 mm, but in your storage tanks, normally some places your aluminum plates are more than 19 mm, but there we are using very low frequency, and we are trying to get the indications from that plate also. So is it clear up till now, sir, Rakesh sir?
Yes, sir.
So after scanning our LFET tank bottom, you can see this computer screen. We are giving this different color coded views of having sketch plate. We are numbering those plates 1, 2, 3, 4, then annular plate A1, A2, A3. We are giving that manual positions and all that. And as per our scanning, we are marking on the drawing that which area is having more than 50% wall loss. We are giving some criteria, 20 to 21 to 30% 31 to 40%. So based on our reports, you can rectify your tank. You can change only that particular area, a particular area which is having bad. You need not to change entire tank. So that is the main advantage. If you know, don't know the condition of your soil side corrosion, you may not able to do the rectification. You may not know which plate has to be changed and which area has to be changed. But by looking at this diagram, you can simply change that particular area where you can find the defects. You can see here some photo gallery in which we found defects while scanning some soil side corrosions with pinholes, soil side corrosion, then product side grooves are there, soil side corrosion then patches, then through holes are there, product holes are also there. So all any type of this type of indications or this type of defects we can identify in the tank and we can produce in our reports and you can do. And based on this report, you can do the rectification. You can see the here. You can see the complete scanning procedure. You can see here the scanner is inside the tank. This is a small video we made for this presentation purpose. You can see here that scanner is there, which is battery operated. You need not to use your power supply in the tank. We are using battery operated system. These are the, you can see the calibration plate as per ASME section 5, article 6. We have to make some artificial flaws. So we have to do the calibration on your calibration plate when you are doing scanning. Sometimes it is not possible to carry calibration plates all the times on the side, but our equipments are calibrated periodically. And whenever we are doing scanning in the tank, we are marking and cross-verifying good region area. Our scanner width is 300 millimeter by 150 millimeter. So we are marking that patch, which is unscanned, or we are making zero means that is good area on that particular plate. We are making that area zero baseline reading, and based on that, we are scanning your entire tank. So you can see here, when we are doing scanning, we are getting indications like this phase and amplitude shift. When we are entering in the tank, we can see here we are marking in the plates, giving sketch plate number 1, 2, 3 like that. Then we are marking the tracks. Our scanner width is 330 mm. So we are marking the track of 300 mm each, because we have to keep some overlap also. So when we are doing 300 millimeter track, again, when next track is there, that is 30 mm overlap is always there. So the reason is we should not miss any indication. After marking this track, we have to go steady and at that particular track, and we have to scan band wise. Each track we have to scan. So here you can see we are doing actual scanning. So when we are doing scanning, we are giving online indications, and whenever we are getting indications and LED lights glow, our operator stops at that particular location, marking the areas and cross verifying with the help of ultrasonic. You can see here. You can see here that top side pit is there. When operator will be on that, exactly on that top, the LED light will glow at that particular location. So our operator will stop there, mark that area. Hitting center of that area, and you can see there that particular pit. So if this pit is from soil side or product side, we are getting similar indications. So when it is top side, it is easy to find, but when it is soil side, it is not hard to find. So for that reason, we have to do ultrasonic cross verification at that particular location. So this is all about LFET. If you have any clarification on this, you can ask me. Rakesh sir, is it clear now? Is it okay?
For me, but participants. It's better to participate. Whether participants
or you can
doubt, you can ask to Mr. Banga.
Participants, unmute. Angani, please go.
Okay. Okay. Then we have vacuum box system also. We imported this system from USA and we are developing in that. We have used this system many places and it can be replaced to your magnetic particle inspection. If your tanks are leaked in welding, that leaks we can find out by using this vacuum box testing. You can see here, we have to use soap water. This is a compressed pump will be there. Then there will be a vacuum box. So after applying your soap water, we have to pneumatically remove the air from that particular area and we can see if any leaks are there. You can see one location is having bubbles. So this is actually some calibration plate we made for this presentation purpose. You can see here that bubbles are there and the leak is there. So like that, you can do your entire tank bottom leak test. Then we have tank shell and column plate inspection by ultrasonic technique by using this Viper crawler. As I told you that we are having that crawler system. This is our system. You can see here the probe will be there. So we are using a digital meter of Olympus from which cable will go. Joystick is in operator's hand. I will show you one video for that also, how it can be scanned and all. You can see here, you need not to erect the scaffolding. Our scanner will go and whenever you want to take the reading, you will get the reading.
Banga sir, how much area?
You can see here, we are getting reading. Oh, what?
How much area is covered by the scanner?
In one direction. And like that, we can take reading in 4 to 8 directions based on your diameter of the tank, basically. If the diameter of the tanks are less than 18 meter, we prefer to take only 4 readings, 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock and 9 o'clock watch position. If tank diameter is more than 40 meter or something like that, we are preferring to take more readings in 8 directions or maybe 12 directions. And along the ladder, you can take reading always. So advantage of using this technique, you need not to erect the scaffolding. Because scaffolding, if you want to erect, it will take too much time and it again costly affair. When you are doing painting and all, at that time it is okay. Because anyhow, you have to erect the scaffolding. But only for thickness gauging, you need not to erect the scaffolding. That is the advantage.
Manga sir, one question.
Yes. No question.
How much time does it take for 30 meter dia, 50 meter high?
30 meter dia, 50 meter high.
Yes. 15.
15 or 50.
15 and 30.
Yeah. But 50 dia, 15, no? You are asking me about 15.
No, 15 meter height and 30 meter dia.
We can preferably take 8 directions. 12 o'clock, then we can take again 4 o'clock. Like that, we can distinguish the that areas. 8 directions. If you want, or six are also fine. If four are, you can take six also. I can't hear you. If somebody is having any questions, you can ask always.
There is one doubt.
Yeah.
Sir, the doubt is that whether we can do the testing of the shell plates directly on the weld joints which are more required, or we need to run through the entire area of the shell course.
So it will go entire area of the shell course. If welds are there, it will, the scanner is magnetic wheel mounted, so it will go on that welds. But if you want to take the readings of that weld area, that is not possible. This is for metal.
Okay, please go ahead.
See, this directions, Rakesh sir, you asked me directions for 30 meter tank. It's depending upon requirements, number of directions can be taken. Means, if you are opening your tank immediately after 5 years or 6 years, I don't think it is required to do all those 8 directions. Because API inspector can tell you better way if he feels that you want to take more readings or something like that. And if you have equipment on site, you can always take a call. You can take your own decisions also. If you want more readings, you can ask our operator to take more readings. So based on that, based on your scope of work, we are just quoting for this work. Normally, some people, I will share you some quotations also, Rakesh sir, personally, so how we are quoting for this API inspection, total solution inspection work.
So this scanner can be used for product tank in service?
Yeah, but it is not intrinsically safe. It is not intrinsically safe. If you are thinking that we can use some magnetic wheel, there might be chances of sparking and all those area. We are not recommending anybody to use on practical in-service tanks.
Okay.
But it can be used, but we are not recommending anybody. And I
permission.
Yeah, if you take permission from the safety people, and if it is advisable, okay, this much this thing friction is not having any issue, then definitely we can use.
And whether this is practically safe or not?
It is not intrinsically safe. We don't have any label or certificate on that, but I don't think nothing has happened when we are
we cannot use.
Sorry?
If it is not intrinsically safe, then we cannot use it in service tank.
Correct. So it's okay. So it is always advisable to use on your in service this thing, out of service tanks only.
Okay.
I'll amend that.
Okay.
And before moving ahead about LFET, I just miss one thing. Many areas in IOCL terminals, people are asking us to scan roof of the scan, this thing, tanks. But in means we are restricted, we are restricting many places due to many reasons. Because if your tank is cone roof tank, lot of structures are there, using LFET on that tanks is not advisable. Because we are getting more erratic indications from that structures and all. So it is not advisable to use LFET on the roof. Even if the tanks are floating roof, there are a lot of undulance and wobbling are there. Thickness is very less. Safety point of view as well as that inspection point of view also, we don't suggest anybody to do tank roof by LFET. But many places people are asking, अरे करो कर लो कुछ नहीं, हम लोग को थोड़ा देखना है क्या है. बहुत प्रेशराइज करने के बाद हम लोग कहाँ कहाँ करते हैं, लेकिन हम लोग बता देते हैं कि ये करने का कुछ जरूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि बेसिकली ये LFET सिस्टम बनाया है आपका टैंक बॉटम के लिए. टैंक बॉटम में आपको सॉइल साइड से क्या हो रहा है, करोजन हो रहा है, इरोजन हो रहा है, वो आपको पता नहीं चलता. इन केस ऑफ रूफ यू कैन सी योर रूफ बोथ साइड्स विजुअली एंड यू कैन मेक आइडिया वेदर रिक्वायर्स एनी रेक्टिफिकेशन ऑर नॉट. जहां पे आपको बॉटम सरफेस है वहां पे आपको कोई पता नहीं चलता है कि सॉइल साइड में क्या करोजन हुआ है क्या है. There definitely this is very much required and we are recommending for that only. Okay.
So roof के लिए भी close UT करना पड़ेगा.
Close UT भी कर सकते हैं सर, mainly visual inspection में आपको बहुत पता चलता है. Visual inspection है हमारा, API inspector एक बार घूम लेगा आपका roof पे और नीचे से torch से देख लेगा, या फिर जितना हो सके उतना closely जाके camera से या ऐसा कुछ देख लेगा कितना fitting है क्या है. So based on their experience, they can tell you what you need to do on that.
Sir, there is a problem. Suppose 15 meter height mera tank hai, 15 meter height. So from 15 meter at bottom, so we are not able to see the exact condition from the underside.
Okay.
Okay, upar ka to dikh jayega from top side. Aap roof pe chalayenge, but 15 meter niche aap khade hue hain. Aur from 15 meter se aap niche dekh rahe hain, aur aapko corrosion dikhega only. Wo fitting aur wo to kuch dikhega nahi. So that is the only reason. जहाँ पे डाउट होता है कि हमको कंडीशन क्या है वो देखने के लिए हम लोग LFET की रिकमेंडेशन देते थे कि रूफ पर LFET करते हैं. अगर LFET नहीं होता तो भी इज बेटर ना.
क्लोज यूटी कीजिए सर, क्लोज यूटी कीजिए, कुछ पैचेस पे कीजिए 100%. और आपको मींस विजुअल में मुझे 15 मीटर योर पॉइंट इज करेक्ट कि 15 मीटर हाइट में आपको एग्जैक्टली दिखेगा नहीं, लेकिन आपको कुछ मैग्नीफाइंग करके उसको क्लोज विजुअल इंस्पेक्शन अगर कर सकते हैं कुछ एक जगह पे स्कैफोल्ड इरेक्ट करके या जो भी कुछ है मूवेबल स्कैफोल्डिंग यूज करके आपको रूफ यू आपका जो रूफ है वो नीचे से अगर आप देख सकते हैं दैट विल बी वेरी इजियर वे टू डू द इंस्पेक्शन. स्कैनिंग हम लोग रिकमेंड इसके लिए नहीं करते हैं कि जैसा लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स रहता है जैसा आप ऊपर से वो स्ट्रक्चर्स का इंडिकेशन आ जाता है, इसके लिए हम लोग उसको रिस्ट्रिक्ट करते हैं कि आप इससे रूफ इंस्पेक्शन मत कीजिए.
यस
ओके ओके. सो दिस वन मोर स्लाइड आई एम शोइंग यू दैट इज मेनली वी आर यूजिंग फॉर बॉयलर वाटर वॉल इंस्पेक्शन. लेकिन मैं आपको इसके लिए दिखा रहा हूँ कि आपके पास काफी पाइपलाइंस रहते हैं और पाइपलाइंस के लिए हमारे पास काफी अच्छी टेक्नोलॉजी है. सेम टेक्नोलॉजी LFET टेक्नोलॉजी वी आर यूजिंग इन कंटूर शेप स्कैनर्स. So, आप यहाँ पे देखेंगे एक स्कैनर है उसके अंदर पे ये सेंसर्स दिख रहे हैं. 8 सेंसर्स आर देयर सो विच आर माउंट ऑन दैट योर प्ले पाइप एंड विच कैन बी स्कैन. सो आपका जैसा टैंक में हम लोग बॉटम इंस्पेक्शन करते हैं वैसा ही पाइपलाइन का पूरा 100% स्कैनिंग करते हैं. तो ये डिफरेंट कंटूर के स्कैनर्स है. You can use for different sizes of pipelines. Like आपका pipeline 2 inch का है तो 2 inch का contour scanner रहेगा, 3 inch का है तो 3 inch contour. So we are having 8 number of scanner. We are having one more system in which that system is called LineCat, in which we are using array of scanners and successfully we completed many pipelines in India like HPCL Mumbai refinery, HPCL Vizag refinery. Recently we did one pipeline in your IOCL Chennai pipeline division. So you can get feedback from there also.
Hello.
Yes sir, sun raha hu.
सर ये बताना ये जो डिस्टिंग साइड ना दिस इज फॉर
एक्सटर्नल इंस्पेक्शन कैन बी डन फ्रॉम इट कैन बी डिटेक्ट एनी डिफेक्ट्स आर inside
for internal this technology is being
sir your voice is not clear
Siddhartha, this is Pranav.
Yeah.
I just want to know this. You said we are scanning from outside, isn't it?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. This is the same technology being used for intelligent pigging for taking the corrosion from inside.
See the technology. If you say it's a same technique. What we are using for storage tank bottom inspection, it is nothing to do with that intelligent pigging. In intelligent pigging, you are inserting the pig inside the pipe and you are getting readings. Or there are other technique called LRUT, long range ultrasonic. There also they are keeping some probes on the different location and they are getting indications. But here it's an online scanning system which can be move from outside of your pipe and which can give you real time data. So आपके LRUT में defect miss होने के काफी chances रहते हैं. आपके intelligent pigging में defect मिलते हैं, लेकिन exact location पता करना उसका मुश्किल रहता है. यहाँ पे आपको advantage ये है कि आपको exact location पे exact size of the defect आपको मिल जाएगा और छोटे से छोटा defect जो कि chances है आपका LRUT में miss हो जाए वो भी मिलने का 100% चांसेस है।
ओके।
तो इसका एक वीडियो मैं आपको दिखा देता हूँ। वो देखने के बाद आपको आइडिया आ जाएगा थोड़ा।
No question. These scanners are again intrinsically safe or not?
We are doing the scanning on your pipelines, live pipelines. Regularly we are doing. So कोई problem नहीं है। But we don't have any certified. बैटरीज के ऊपर हम लोग 12 वोल्ट डीसी बैटरीज इसके लिए यूज करते हैं
सर वो ठीक है बट आपको भी मालूम है कि जो पेट्रोलियम इंडस्ट्री है या पेट्रोलियम जो टर्मिनल डिपोज है तो उसके अंदर अगर वो कोई भी इक्विपमेंट यूज कर रहा है तो आइदर इट शुड बी इंट्रिंसिकली सेफ और फ्लेम प्रूफ सो हाउ कैन वी यूज दिस स्कैनर विदाउट हैविंग सर्टिफिकेट्स
करेक्ट सर वो रिस्ट्रिक्शन है लेकिन मैं आपके इंफॉर्मेशन के लिए बताना चाहता हूँ कि जो आपका दिल्ली के बाजू में पानीपत में जो 5.5 किलोमीटर का जो गैस का पाइपलाइन था रिफाइनरी से लेके आपका एक कोई टर्मिनल है वो 5.5 किलोमीटर का लाइन वो जमीन के अंदर था तो उसको कुछ कोटिंग रैपिंग चेंज करने के लिए उन्होंने इंस्पेक्ट किया था तो वो टाइम में हमने ये लाइन का इंस्पेक्शन पूरा थ्रू आउट द पाइपलाइन उनका किया था
आउटसाइड तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है बट इनसाइड टर्मिनल जो है ना
इनसाइड टर्मिनल में भी अभी तक तो किया नहीं है लेकिन होपफुली वी विल डू दैट
crawler will be traveling unmanned or it has to be manned. What I mean to say that suppose some of the places it will not be accessible to go physically by somebody. You got my point.
Sir, it's a manual scanning. We have to scan scanner. And whichever that pipe supports are there, some restrictions are there. There we cannot do that. Only आपका जो बेयर सरफेस है पाइप का उसके लिए भी आपका बॉटम से क्लियरेंस होना जरूरी है स्कैनिंग के लिए दोनों साइड में जो पाइपलाइन यू आर गोइंग टू यूज इंस्पेक्ट आपका एटलीस्ट 1 फीट उसका चारों बाजू में से सरफेस एरिया ओपन सरफेस होना चाहिए ताकि वी कैन स्कैन इट
प्लीज गो अहेड अगर सर थोड़ा सा टाइम भी देख लीजिए नेक्स्ट की फैकल्टी का भी है प्लीज
ये और एक टेक्नोलॉजी है वेल्ड के लिए बैलेंस फील्ड एडीकरण करके व्हिच इज बेसिकली वी आर यूजिंग इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्ड अगेन हियर एंड स्कैनर्स रहेगा आपका जो वेल्ड में कुछ क्रैकिंग हो रहा है सरफेस क्रैकिंग तो इंस्टेड ऑफ आपका एमपीआई या डीपी यूज करने से अच्छा है आप ये यूज करेंगे तो आपका वेल्ड में कहीं पे कुछ वेल्डिंग के ऊपर पेंट है तो आपको पेंट रिमूव करने की जरूरत नहीं रहेगा ये पेंट के ऊपर भी स्कैनिंग होगा और कहीं पे कुछ क्रैक्स रहेगा तो वो पता चल जाएगा बट दिस इज ओनली फॉर क्रैकिंग आप सरफेस सब सरफेस आप पोरासिटी या बाकी के कुछ डिफेक्ट उसमें सस्पेक्ट कर रहे हैं तो उसके लिए ये टेक्नोलॉजी नहीं है क्रैकिंग जो स्ट्रेस क्रैक्स है और सरफेस क्रैक है उसके लिए ये टेक्नोलॉजी बहुत अच्छा है तो ये भी हम लोग रिसेंटली इंट्रोड्यूस किया और काफी सारा जगह में हम लोग वी आर यूजिंग दिस
मींस यू मीन वी कैन यूज इंस्टेड ऑफ डीपी टेस्ट वी कैन यूज दिस टेक्नोलॉजी
इनके टू चेंज एमपीआई मैग्नेटिक पार्टिकल इंस्पेक्शन वेर एवर योर टैंक मान लीजिए आपका कोई टैंक में आपका पेंट बहुत अच्छी तरह से इंटैक्ट है और आप उसको रिमूव नहीं करना चाहते लेकिन आप वो वेल्ड को इंस्पेक्ट करना चाहते देन यू कैन यूज देयर दिस लाइन कैट टेक्नोलॉजी
ओके
टू फाइंड द क्रैक्स सो दिस इज अ लाइन कैट सिस्टम यू कैन सी हियर दैट स्कैनर इज देयर एरे ऑफ स्कैनर्स आर देयर बेस्ड ऑन योर पाइपलाइन साइज डायमीटर ऑफ द पाइप सो वो स्कैन करते जाता है और when we are scanning we are getting indications fittings corrosion jo bhi soil science hai jo bhi hai same jaisa aapka LFET mein tank floor mein milta hai same indication isme bhi milte hai aur aap exactly wo location pe jaake usko cross verify kar sakte hai ultrasonic se aur you can rectify after our reports
ha ji yes sir.